From the Johnson's Wax Research Tower in Racine, Wisconsin, come work-saving waxes and polishes that are used around the world. And now the makers of Johnson's Wax present the exciting television game, The Name's the Same. Now, let's meet our panel of famous names. Famous radio and television humorist, Bill Cullen. Famous radio and television actress, Joan Alexander. Well-known composer, conductor, and author, Meredith Wilson. And your host and moderator, another famous name who opens tomorrow at Boston's famous Latin Quarter, Robert Q. Lewis.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to The Name's the Same. Tonight, as usual, you're going to meet some people who have very famous names. Names the same as famous celebrities, well-known places, and things that we all know. And tonight, as always, it's up to our trio of experts over here to figure out those famous names via process of cross-examination. Well, before our panel puts their thinking caps on, well, sir, here's an interesting message. Thank you, sir. And now let's meet our first guest with a famous name.
Now, first of all, where are you from, sir?
I'm from Fort Wright, Kentucky.
I see. And what do you do?
A manufacturing engineer.
All right, sir. Now, of course, it's true that you have a famous name, and if you don't mind, I'll refer to you as Mr. X from now on, so we don't give away your name by accident. For submitting this name to us, we're sending $10 to Mrs. Joseph Halpin of Fort Thomas, Kentucky. Fort Thomas, is that your hometown, too?
No, that's across the...
Well, she went through some phone books to get your name. Let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. Now, this is really your name, isn't it?
That's right.
One thing I'd like to point out, ladies and gentlemen, every one of the names, every single one of the names that we employ on The Name's the Same is authentic. The real names, we look at birth certificates and other various verifications. All right, panel, it's up to you to see if you can determine what this gentleman's famous name is. You remember our rules. You're competing with one another to see who guesses his famous name first. The losers pay. You have 10 questions apiece. If you use your questions up, you must lose and pay your money or just immediate. I don't... these rules get more confused every week. At any rate, you have 10 questions. Yes or no is all you may answer. $25 apiece if you lose. Let's start this round with Meredith Wilson.
Oh, good evening, sir. Are you living?
Yes.
Have you made appearances on radio and television?
Yes.
You make most of your money from acting?
No.
From acting? No.
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 Oh, wait a minute. Are you a movie director?
No.
Are your talents musical?
Yes.
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 You're sober and they're laughing. I don't know.
Well, there are all kinds of music.
Well, are you a singer?
No.
Do you play a musical instrument?
Yes.
How many questions have I got?
You have three, man.
Oh, I think I'll husband them and sit back and get a little information from Mr. Cullen.
Bill, welcome back.
Oh, good to be here, Bob. He's going to husband his questions, huh?
Yes,
have you ever, Mr. X, have you ever played an instrument on television?
Yes.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, then, has most of your playing been off of television?
Yes.
Are you about to go on an extended tour of some kind?
An extended... I think we'd have to...
No,
we don't want to mislead you, Bill.
All right. Do you have, then... I have another idea. Do you have a definite Russian accent by any chance?
No.
Have you been playing in one establishment for a long period of time?
I would say yes to that, yes.
Yes.
Then is your music the kind of thing is called the sweetest music this side of heaven?
No,
that's... No, that's another musician.
Well, I think I'll husband my questions and turn it over to Joan Alexander.
Joan Alexander.
We haven't established what you are. Are you, by any chance, something other than a musician?
Yes.
Are you in politics, by any chance?
I beg pardon?
Are you in politics?
Yes.
You are in politics. Are you about to be replaced by someone who's not quite so musical?
Don't think that's a very nice way to talk about me.
Yes.
Oh, that's a replacement. I'm sorry. Whenever I hear that word, replaced by someone who is not quite so musical, well, I don't know about that.
Well, are you about to be replaced?
Yes.
Do you hold a high federal office?
Yes.
Is it the presidency of the United States?
Yes.
Are you Harry S. Truman?
Harry Truman. For the benefit of those stations who may get our show on Kinescope, this is ex-president Harry Truman. All right, very good panel. Bill and Meredith, write out your checks for $25. Mr. Truman, you're from Kentucky.
That's
right. Well, sir, you may, you're going to go back there, but you, the both Trumans are making themselves a little trip this week. Thank you very much. Go on over there, pick up your checks, and thanks so much from Johnson for playing the name for Sam.
Truman?
Are you any relation, Mr. Truman?
Hail to the chief.
And now let's meet our next guest with a famous name.
Hi. Let me get some phone books for you, young man.
We got the Manhattan and the Bronx phone book. That ought to do it.
Let me see if I can get you in here.
How old are you?
Six.
Six?
Where are you from?
Kirkwood, Missouri.
Missouri?
Uh-huh.
That should have been the last contestant. All right. Now, we know you've got a famous name. We're all anxious to take a look at it. Let's let our home audience see this young gentleman's famous name. All right, panel, you remember our rules. You have 10 questions, Mr. X. You may answer yes or no as if you were the famous person whose name you bear. If you panelists run out of questions, you lose. Must pay our contestant your check for $25. Let's see how you do this time. Joni, you smile very nicely, and you did well last time. You start now.
Are you living, honey?
Yes.
You are. I'm glad. You're awful cute. are you in the arts, by any chance?
Yes.
You are. Are you a male?
Yes.
Well, I'll pass, Bill.
Yes, that's right.
Me?
Yeah.
No, to Meredith.
After 2 years?
Oh, I beg your
pardon.
My dear.
I haven't been thinking yet. Go ahead, Meredith.
Mine forms on the right, I thought.
The glasses are confusing.
Sorry, darling.
Let me see. Living and in the arts. Are you in television?
Yes.
Well, Meredith, the answer is correct, but that's sort of a broad...
Not primarily, I would say.
Well, he's appeared in television. Let's give you that.
Yes. Are you a picture actor, young man?
Yes.
A picture. You notice
no sucking of thumbs on this program.
Bob, I hope you noticed the cagey way I formed that question. Are you a picture actor?
I noticed the way.
Yes, I just want to get all the information I could. Picture actor, are you a leading man?
No.
No, you're not. Do you have any identifying...
Leading man in the sense of Clark Gable, shall we say.
Yeah, well, romantic, you're leading man.
Je comprends.
Yes. Yes, do you have any identifying physical characteristics?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Are they facial?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Do you have anything particularly striking about your proboscis?
Well, just a minute. Excuse me for just a moment.
Yeah.
What is proboscis?
No.
Oh, you don't have anything striking about your proboscis. I passed, Mr. Cullen.
In other words, I'm to assume you've never been struck in a proboscis. Is that the idea? But you do have something. I think the thing that's unusual about you is your tongue there, the way you got it going.
Well, I'm sorry. Here, put the thumb back in.
Listen, this thing that's unusual on your face, sir, is it? Could it possibly be your eyes?
No.
Well, that's close. Could it be your ears?
No.
Could it be your mouth?
No.
I'm running out of face. could it be your hair?
Yes.
All righty. Would it be that you have a funny kind of hair, or would it be that you don't have any hair at all?
No.
I'm glad, because I don't know anyone without any hair at all. Would it be that you have peculiar hair? I mean, a lot of it. Let's put it that way, because I got...
A lot of it?
A lot of hair.
Yes.
Are you part of a team?
No.
You have three questions. I'm going to pass to Joan Alexander, because
right.
I just lost my idea.
Now, I'll give you this little bit of help. On the hair, that's as much help as I'll give you. Now, go ahead.
On the hair?
Thanks a lot, Bob.
Are you known as a comedian?
Yes.
And you're not part of a team? Now, that's a review. You're not part of a team?
No. Hair is assumes different positions on various people's...
You mean it's fallen off?
Well, you said it wasn't the lack of hair.
No, it was not.
Is it blonde hair?
No.
Red hair?
No.
Black hair?
No.
Wait a minute.
Green hair?
Let me give you this little bit of help. The hair is to be found not only on top of the scalp, on many people. Now, if you'd like to continue.
But he also has a beard.
Yes.
He has a beard?
Yes.
Oh, golly. Were you in a play...
You have two questions.
...many seasons back called The Man Who Came to Dinner?
Yes.
Yes, well, it must be Monty Woolley. Sorry about that. I'm not here.
That's very good. Bill and Mert, if you write out your checks for $25... Now, before you go over to get those checks, young man, I think I have a real treat for you tonight. Have you ever met the famous actor whose name you bear?
No.
You haven't?
No.
Well, we have a real treat for you. Ladies and gentlemen, the great star of the Broadway stage and motion pictures, Mr. Monty Woolley.
Miss Monty, you go on over there and pick up your checks from Meredith and from Bill Cullen, and thanks so much from the makers of Johnson's Wax for playing The Names the Same. Go on, young man.
Atta boy, Monty. Well, this, Monty, but welcome to New York, and also welcome to The Names the Same.
Thank
Pleasure
you.
To have you on. I think all of us have enjoyed you so very much. We come now to the I'd Like to Be portion of The Names the Same, and before the show started, Mr. Woolley told us who he might like to be, just in fun, of course, if he were not himself. Right, now we're set to play I'd Like to Be. Before we do, again, welcome. What are you doing in New York, Mr. Woolley?
Here for this show.
Egad, we've done it again.
Well, I came also to hear, see the what the effect of the bus strike was.
Have you been walking?
Yeah, I've been walking.
Well, we're glad you got over here tonight. All right, panel, let's see if you can find out who it is Monty Woolley would like to be, just in fun, of course. Let's let our home audience see the famous name. No, they can't see that. Well, because we fixed it. Now, panel, we play the same as before, and the loser's checks will go to Monty Woolley's favorite charity. Let's start this round off with Bill Cullen.
All right. Mr. Woolley, this famous person you want to be, is it a man?
Yes.
Is he alive?
Yes.
Is he in the arts?
Yes.
I gather by that inflection, he is not what you would call a leading man-type actor.
Do I have to answer that?
Well... Not if they don't count it against me. I'll give a... is he a leading man type actor?
No.
Thanks. Is he an actor at all? I should have asked that first.
Yeah.
He is? I'm going to give him to Joan Alexander. I'll save mine.
Is he a comedian by any chance?
No.
Has he appeared in motion pictures?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Of course.
Yes?
Yes?
Has he appeared as another character or has himself?
Himself.
Does he do anything else besides be in the entertainment business? Is he noted for something else?
Not that I know of.
Not that you know of? Not politics or sports or anything like that? Well, I'll pass to Meredith.
Yes, good evening, Monty. I think the last time we were together, you sang "May the Good Lord Bless and Keep You" on the big show. Surprised everyone with your dulcet tones. May I ask you to get back to the matter at hand? Is this a person that you want to be, does he resemble you in any way?
No.
In no way at all, hirsutely or any other way?
His suit doesn't seem to me to be at all like...
No.
I see. Is this gentleman perhaps noted for his romantic appeal to the opposite sex?
I think it might be...
Would this gentleman oftentimes be appropriately dressed in a leopard skin?
I don't know.
No. Well, I'm on the wrong track. I'll pass the bill.
Bill.
I can't think of anyone being appropriately dressed in a leopard skin.
Not even a leopard, but go ahead.
I've seen some leopards that didn't look good in them. This fellow that you would like to be, Monty, is he a very virile, a husky fellow?
No.
Oh, well, that throws me. Is this fellow known for some things aside from his acting? I mean, not his primary fame, but does his fame come from something that he does outside the motion picture world of theater? Outside activities?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are they the kind of activities that most of us would like to indulge in from time to time?
Most of us would like to indulge in?
Well, me, for instance. And you, too. I'll bring you along on this.
Yeah, I think we'd like to indulge in it. I mean, that's,
I'm off the track.
I am, too.
And
you have two questions, Bill.
And you are primarily a motion picture actor, though that's
not
the way...
Not primarily,
you...
no.
Oh,
charge
oh,
that
no.
question, please.
I'm going to say Tommy you... Manville and then pass.
No. All right.
Are you a producer by any chance?
No.
You're not a producer?
No.
Oh, I thought it was Billy Rose. Oh, well.
Let's keep it rolling.
Are you an American?
Yes.
Are you a young man?
Yes.
Under 40?
Yes.
Do you have any distinguishing physical characteristics?
That would be hard. No, I don't think so. You have one question, Joni.
Oh, it is a producer? We've
determined that it is not a producer.
It's not a producer. You well, have... I one question I passed.
All right, Meredith.
Is this man, he doesn't do anything else in the profession. I mean, does he sing?
Yes.
Oh,
he does sing.
Yes. Oh, I know.
Is he singing in pictures now?
You would not know him primarily for this, and I have... Sorry, but our time is just about up. Monty Woolley would like to be Johnny Ray.
Oh,
Johnny Ray. That is a toughie, I grant you that. But very good try, anyway. Mr. Woolley,
I'm going to ask you to go... Yes. I wished I could use that lip work that my predecessor here did.
You go on and pick up your checks from Bill, Joan, and Meredith, and thanks so much to the makers of Johnson's Wax for playing the names of the song.
You've been wonderful. Good to see you.
I'd rather be you than Johnny Ray.
Now let's meet our next guest with a famous name.
Hi.
May I ask once again where you're from?
Dublin.
Dublin, indeed. Well, how nice. And what do you do?
I'm a housewife and I'm a minister's wife.
Well, very good. Before we play our game, I think we ought to let our home audience see this lady's famous name. Once again, I'd like to advise you that we know this is the lady's name because our legal experts have checked its authenticity. Panel, let's go to work on this young lady over here. We'll call you Miss X from now on just to avoid any problems. Let me tell you that Miss X's name is an action. An action. And with that, suppose we start with Joni.
Could I do this?
Yes.
Is it necessary for me to have special equipment and... And implements to do this?
No.
Is it more... Well, would I do this for a living?
No. Very definitely not.
Then is it more in the nature of being amusing and recreational?
No.
It would be... You say no, my dear? Let's say that many people would find it amusing and recreational.
Would I do this at the beach?
Well, I think you might. Yes, 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 very definitely, as a matter of fact, surely.
Well, if I were going to the beach to do this, would I buy a new bathing suit?
No.
Oh, do amateurs hold their nose when they do this?
Well, do they, darling? I don't believe so. Not being an amateur, I wouldn't know, but I don't... I don't think so, Joni, no.
I pass.
Meredith?
Well, must this be done at the beach?
No.
Was this done in metropolitan areas, like here in New York?
In New York?
Yeah.
I would say it was done quite frequently in New York. How about Dublin, Miss X? Yeah, that's a metropolitan. Yeah. We have about 2 minutes, ma'am.
Well, has the bus strike interfered with this a great deal in New York?
No, I don't think.
Is this done on the golf course?
Could be.
Yes.
It is? Uh-huh. Could be.
Yeah.
Well, if a man doesn't know how to do this right, does his caddy generally help him?
Are you a golfer, Miss Hanks? No, I don't. No.
Well, I'm in hot water. I'll pass.
All right, Bill, in about a minute.
We've been to the beach and we've been to the golf course. I'm going back home. Could you do this in the living room? Would you be apt to damage the place at all when you did this?
No.
Would you? Is it the kind of a thing that ordinarily that takes two people to do?
Yes.
Is your first
name... Well, now, as a matter of fact, it would not necessarily take two people, would it?
Really?
No, it would
no.
not. It would
no.
not.
Oh, you couldn't... No, it would have to be the one I'm thinking. Is this an action of very heavy friendship? I mean, does it go beyond friendship?
Yes.
Is it love, by any chance?
Yes.
Is your first name, I?
No.
No?
You have 30 seconds.
Your first name isn't Mother, is it?
No.
It's like the mother love.
You have three questions.
Joan, if you have an idea, I'll pass to you, because I haven't any more...
May?
May!
May, that's right.
You got it.
May Love, and I think that is a very, very pretty name, Mrs. Love.
Thank you very much.
That is certainly... Of course, Joni, I don't see how... Have you golfed much lately, Meredith? The wonderful thing about love is that you just have it anywhere in the whole wide world.
That's right.
How long have you been married to Mr. Love?
19 years.
Love with love for 19 years. That's very, very lovely.
Reverend Love.
The Reverend Love, of course. Meredith, Joan, Bill, will you write out your checks for $25 each? Mrs. Love, it is with love and checks that we bid you good night. We ask you to go over there to pick up your checks and say thank you so much for the makers of Johnson's Wax for playing the name of the song.
That's all we need to do with the one.
The panel and I will be back in a moment, folks, to tell you how they did and a little bit about next week's show. All right, panel, let's see how we did tonight. Joni, you seem to me to do pretty darn well. Let's have a little accounting. Meredith, you start. Make your...
Oh, yes, I'll get mine over quickly. I did badly. $100, good night.
Meredith Wilson. Joan Alexander, how about you?
$25, but I can thank Bill for that last one. Good night, everybody.
All right, Bill, how about the last one and the rest, too?
Well, I lost $100, but I'm happy 25 of it went to Harry S. Truman. And good night.
Good night, panel. You did very, very well. Again, next week, another series of famous names on The Names the Same. We hope you'll be able to join us. It's good night from the makers of Johnson's Wax. The panel and I will see you again next week on The Names the Same, which will be brought to you by C.A. Swanson and Sons.
The Names the Same has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.
Look who's winning on GSN.
I won.
We won, and you can too.
Go to GSN.com.
And print your own bingo cards.
We print out 10 cards per game.
Each 10 for me, 10 for her.
Bingo America.
It pays to play.
Bingo America, tomorrow at 7 p.m., 6 Central.